adjust the cheek is up. Break it down so I can beat it up. With a welcome back, with a welcome back. My sink is tough. This is for my old head. Go on, turn your speakers up. Rocky, where you been? I've been trying to make my ends meet. So I can count that bathing ape. The Germans got a dandy. Bottles full of rose, riding in the Benz. Throwing money fast. Now I'm finna think I'm big.
What's going on, YouTube? What's going on, YouTube? This your man Zidane 9 coming at you with a astrological resource. And I just want to start off saying I'm an astrologist at first, you know? I'm so fascinated with it. So today I'm going to talk about Capricorn and Neptune. And Neptune rules Pisces. And Pisces is imagination. Pisces is water. So, being my Capricorn placed in Neptune, I'm gonna break it down. I'm gonna chop it down on my studies so far. I only did about like five years. So I'm gonna chop it down, okay? Now, since the Capricorn is placed in the Neptune, shout out to what's that producers group with Pharrell and them? You already know. Okay. It has nothing to do with that. Okay. So if Capricorn is placed in Neptune, Neptune is the ruler of imagination, creativity, fantasy life, and fantasy. The imagination. The Final Fantasies. The Wizard of Oz. The Disney. The Final Fantasies, you know, of the Zodiac. The Dreamers, the true clouds in the air, dragons, flying dragons, unicorns, the Dreamers. Now, since my Capricorn is a cardinal sign, leader of the Zodiac, and it's an earth sign, it's compatible with Neptune. So, being a cardinal sign, I'm a leader in my imagination and my visionary. That's the word I was looking for, visionary. And also, it rules visionary, you know, stuff to do with fairy tales, like, Neverland, like Peter Pan, you know, aspects like that. And, since my Capricorns are known to being serious, when I tend to fantasize and daydream, I am serious. I'm serious about what exactly I am fantasizing about or in a dream state about. You know, Pisces is a magical sign. It's a very magical sign. So Capricorn in the placement, I say that's pretty good. And listen, if astrology users, you're listening to me right now, go to alwaysastrology.com. Very good site, excellent site at that, great site. It gives you all the nice information that you want to know about astrology. It gives you a lot of good intel, a lot of good information. So listen, I'm trying to gather people across YouTube, all the astrologers, and just help me out, and we can help each other with brainstorming and just exchanging ideas and zodiacs, so we can exercise our brain and our studies. So just gather everybody, and my viewers listening and even my subscribers, hit me back on the inbox and give me more insight and more detail on my Capricorn being in Neptune, because that's the ruler of Pisces. And they cohab very well. Capricorn is the ruler of Saturn. So that's responsibility. That's another video. But you're fusing. Okay? You're fusing Saturn and Neptune together. Basically, a fusion of Pisces and Capricorn. Capricorn is like the father, the serious, the Well, any of my viewers, you ever see? Give example. Capricorn is the drill sergeant, and Pisces is the green beret. Yeah, kind of losing y'all, but my true fans, hit me back. Because Capricorn and Neptune sounds like a very magical place for me. I just want to say, holla back what y'all think on it.
You'll be straight.
And I'll add a little more. Capricorn is very responsible and stable. So when I have visionaries, or if I lay back and have visionaries, they're very deep and they're very serious and they're structured. You know, it's not as wild or random. It's very structured and organized. So I wanted to point that out. You know, think of a fusion of a real business like a Donald Trump fused with the director of Wizard of Oz, or Chronicles of Narnia fusion, a black and white real business work. That's the fusion. You understand? And I recommend you guys to look up Excellent Brother. He said layers, astrology is like layer after layer. It's a lifetime study. It takes years, and that's the beautiful thing about it, because we can never get, us being students, astrologists, we can never get tired of the studies, because it's a lifetime. There's so much to it. So I just want to say, keep studying my astro students, my prospects, my prodigies, and let's come together and brainstorm and get all the information we can, and we could talk about this, and we could solve more, we can make more discoveries, even though in the past they mapped it out, but we can make more discoveries, new forms and stuff like that. So that'll be a great look. So hit me up, Astro fans, I'm here, Z94.
Like some codes, or is it really good? Money tell me so. Prince turn phones, they be fake. If you listen to your old head, so you'll be straight.
Thank you, YouTube, for listening. I really appreciate y'all for listening, to having your ears what I got to say.